everyone. This is Ray. I would like to share that this is my new YouTube channel. I am going to be doing a tag-along Tuesday on our Facebook page that I'm a part of. That is www.facebook.com/scrapmaidens. Now, that page has a lot of lovely ladies on it, and if you would like to join, please definitely do. We love new people, we love new ideas, we love just sharing our ideas, our crafts, our DIYs. So if that sounds like you, head over there and add that Facebook page. Now, the reason why I am filming today is because we wanted to do the tag-along Tuesday, of course, and I promised the first video would be about making these paper flowers. Let me see if I'm in camera. There we go. And they can come in many different sizes, and I did these ones ahead of time. Now, what you'll need for this is your scallop punches. Now, they do not have to be Stampin' Up or Martha Stewart. This is the smaller size, and this is the big scallop. I think there's one more size that's bigger than this, but I don't think it's by Stampin' Up. I think it's like EK Success or whatever. It can be any of them. As long as it's scalloped, then you'll get the desired look like those. You're going to need some distress ink. You're going to need your distressor. Now, you're going to need warm water. It has to be, like, not super hot, but it just needs to be hot enough so that it can crinkle the paper up and get the desired look that we're trying to go for. And we also need a piece of cardstock. Yes, it is made out of cardstock. I mean, you can use paper, but that's going to be very fragile. You're also going to need some brads. I'm using these really, really tiny recollection brads because I wanted to maybe put a centerpiece in some of these. And you don't want to put a super big one in there so that you see the brad instead of the centerpiece. But you can use whatever you choose. So I'm going to hurry up and get started because I don't know how much exact time I have on my camera. So what we're first going to do is we're going to punch out our scallops. And I am going to use the big scallop because we're going to use the big one first. We're going to punch out 8 of these. That one was a dud. Gotta be careful. Don't get too close to the edge, ladies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. I did forget to mention you do have to have some type of piercer so that it will go through all of these scallops. You want to make a previous hole before you put the actual brad in there, so it's easier to get in there for you. So that's what I'm going to do real quick, is just pierce it right in the middle. Might take a second. I'm using just a needle. If you don't have a paper piercer, that's what I preference of using. See, and it will go straight to the back. So you just wiggle that around so you get the hole big enough. And I forgot to add that where I found this idea from was Pinkaboo 699, I do believe. I'll have to definitely at the end of the video get the correct YouTube channel to her link to the video that I got this idea from. So we're going to spread these out. And what we're first going to do before we spray these with water is we're going to pick our distress ink. And I'm going to choose the pink one in the spirit of Valentine's Day. And what you're going to do is just take the scallop and start inking the edges. You can go all the way to the center, but for me, I just like doing the edges to get the desired look that I'm going for. So we're just going to ink the edges. And we're going to do that to all 8 of them. It's easy and quick. And it's going to be super fun. And it takes you no time at all. I accomplished those 3, I do believe, within 15-20 minutes. So if you want to make these for a mini album, a card, or if you are in a hurry, then this is for you. Because it definitely, definitely helps. And that's what I love about it. It is quick and easy to do. Just 3 more. Now I'm probably going to zoom in for you guys to see it a little bit closer here in a second. So don't mind me if I move the camera a little bit. Alright, let me move the camera, move some stuff out of the way real quick. Okay, so the next step is make sure you have a mat underneath you, because when you spray this water, it is going to go all over the place. And make sure that your electronics or inks, etc., is out of the way. So we're going to take our spray bottle and spray a gentle amount all over the flowers. And don't worry about if the flowers run, because what you can do is you can come back in later when it's dry and re-ink the edges. So that's not a problem there. And the next step, what we're going to do is, while they're damp, is crinkle them up. I know it looks silly, but crinkle them up as much as you can. One by one. Okay, and this is going to get messy because the ink is going to run off on your hands because of the water, but that's okay. Make sure you have a wiper, a towel nearby for you if you want to. I personally don't care because I love doing it. And getting my hands dirty, I should say. So what the next step is you're going to unravel them and layer them on top of each other. And like I said, if they start feeling a little dry, you could always, when you put the brad in, is re-spray it before you crinkle it back up to make the desired look of the flower that you would like. And I will show you that in here in a second. Make sure I'm in frame here. There we go. And you have to be careful because they will tear because it is damp. That one teared a little bit, but you're not going to see that when you crinkle up your flower. So it is very easy to fix. So I'm going to take this little brad, and one by one I'm going to stick it through all the flower holes. Well, I should say scallops, but they will be flowers here in a minute. And just work your way. And I am using a smaller brad, so it is going to be hard if you're using a smaller brad. And that's what I used my clamping tool for, is I'm going to, when I get it all the way through here, I'm going to push it down so it's secure. And it's not a problem because you can bend these over really easy. And then you push it on the table. Okay, and then you're going to end up with something like this. And then you're going to have all these bunches of scallops, stacked up like so. The next step is take your water, if it feels dry, like mine feels a little dry, and respray it with a gentle amount. And then the next step is we're going to take the very first one, and that's the one we're going to start crinkling first. And then you're going to pick up every other layer as you go. And then you're going to keep crinkling. Smush it, bend it, but I like to squish it together first. Oops, sorry, I'm a little out of frame. Let me zoom in for you guys. Okay. And I'm going to keep crinkling. Layer by layer, you pull up. Don't pull too tight or you're going to rip it. And almost done here. So you're going to have something like that. Whoops. Apparently I went too far. The camera can't see that. Sorry about the blur, guys. Camera's having a fit, I guess. Okay. So continuing on, after the camera had a little hissy fit, you're going to have something that looks like this once you're pulling up all the layers. Now the very last layer, I wouldn't crinkle all the way up because you want some type of flatness on the bottom so that you can use this as your base. Okay. And then you're going to have something sort of like this. I mean, everyone's is going to be different, and every flower you make is going to be different. So, this is what you'll have at first. And then what you do is you mess with it, you crinkle it around, flatten it, push it back up, get the desired look of your choice. Now, everyone's flower will be more fluffy, more flat. It's all about preference. And like I said, your ink is going to run off most of these pieces of scallops, but at the very end when it starts to dry, you can come back in with your Tim Holtz Distress Ink and re-ink the edges, and it turns out really beautiful. It actually gives it a the desired look of distressed or desired look of, you know, shabby chic, what have you. Now, this flower is giving me a tough time. It's probably because I'm on camera, of course. But, you just gotta squish it around. Like I said, it's getting a little dry, so you wanna revamp it a little bit. Okay. And there you go, folks. This is the paper flowers. Aren't they gorgeous? And you can put these on a mini album. I don't have anything to reference. Maybe let's just use this envelope. Let's just say this is on a mini album. You can use these as, you can make them with a little scallop too. I don't have a whole lot of time to do that, but you can do, it's the same steps as the big flower, and you can combine them, and they make a really, really gorgeous setup on mini albums, cards, whatever project you're trying to do. Now, like I said, this flower's looking a little dry, so we can put some more ink on there. This one I wanted to make a little darker, a little different than the other one. And you're just inking the edges for this one. So you're getting that desired distressed look. And that is it. So, if you would like to ask any questions, do not hesitate, because I will be more than happy to help you. If I went a little too fast in the video, I can also break it down for you below in the caption of what you need and all the supplies if you want to. So just comment if you have any questions. Now, I also wanted to say at the very end of this video, this is a little early. It's not supposed to be for Tag Along Tuesday. I kind of fibbed a little bit to hide the surprise. This video was actually going to be made today. Today is Thursday. And I'm going to be doing the, we'll do it on Tuesday. I will be giving away a prize of a bunch of goodies, which I will show you real quick. Now, the only requirements for this giveaway is you must be added on our Facebook page. That is www.facebook.com/scrapmaidens. Now, that's the only requirement. You can either comment on my YouTube video or on the video link on the Facebook page. The drawing will be held on Tuesday. I would probably say in the morning I will do the giveaway. The only other requirement I ask is when you comment, tell me a little bit about what made you get into scrapbooking. What makes you most happy about it? How has it changed your life? And how does it help you, others, like therapy-wise? Anything like that you can tell me. And that will be one of the entries for you to be put into the contest. I did a bag of fibers. Laces and rosette trims, one bag of fabric flowers, really pretty, a random bag of metal embellishments, which are flowers, butterflies, a bunch of paper flowers, and then there's some pins in here. This is a vellum bag, and then this is a paper bag. These wooden pieces here are mason jars for tags. You can stamp on those, you can paint those. I know that there's some sprays in here for flowers I put in there, and then some paper clips and whatever else. Then you're going to get a 3-pack of these beautiful butterflies. They do have a spot in the back. You can glue them to projects, or you can take that metal piece and adhere them to other things. A pack of decorative buttons, a pack of little envelopes with the cards you can stamp on, one doily, one paper pack, it's really cute, and then this 6x6 paper bed by Melissa Francis. It's called C'est la vie. It's gorgeous papers. It's really shabby chic colors, like the blues and the pinks and the whites and the creams. And then last but not least, for my personal collection, I got a bunch of these from my dear friend Joni. She sent me a bunch of these vintage bingo cards, and yes, this is a real one. And I will be also giving that in this prize package. Again, if you want to enter, you have to add the Facebook page, which I will link below also if you don't catch it in the video. And again, you just need to tell me what crafting has done for you, how it's changed your life, etc. And I will see you guys back on Tuesday. Thanks so much. Have a good day, and see you later. Bye.